Hello, world. I'm Landon. I'm home alone on a Friday night, and there's nothing else to do. I mean, earlier I tried to heat up some pastaroni. It said Best Buy September 2007, but that's just a suggestion. Well, kind of, because actually it turned out to be a type of really weird soup. It wasn't Alfredo. It was a soupy pasta thing. But besides the point. So I'm here alone on Friday night, again, in the basement because monsters could be out there. I mean, my dog is just upstairs, so he'll protect me. So, today I want to talk about mothers for a second, since Mother's Day is on Sunday, and mothers are so great. Without them, none of us would be here, because we are from their womb, and they gave birth to us. So my mom, her name is Michelle, and she has 7 children, including me, 8 if you count the adopted one. She didn't give birth to him, but it's all the same. And 9 grandchildren. The point is that my mother is one of the best people that I know because she's so selfless and loving, and she cares about other people way more than herself. And it's just great, you know? For a second, or two, I want to talk about all the things that my mom has done for me. For Christmas, a couple years ago, I wrote up a list of everything she's ever done for me, and then I added to it on Mother's Day, but the list was typed about 5 pages with detailed descriptions of exactly how many meals she's made me and how many times she's driven me places. And moms are actually quite amazing. My mother, in fact, she got me my job as a janitor at Mountainville Academy, where I currently janitor, and she is the almost everything there. She is the nurse, the facilities director, the testing person. She is an office lady. She takes care of the special needs kids. She does a lot of stuff there. She texted me one day last year, like February of 2013. She's like, "Hey, do you want a job?" And I was like, "Sure." And she was like, "Okay, you're hired." And I was like, "Well, that was the easiest interview process I've ever gone through." Just an example of what she has to put up with as I work there. Let me read you these texts today. She wanted me to auto scrub the gym, but the gym smells gross, like BO and ham sandwiches that kind of have BO on them. And so she wanted me to auto scrub the gym, and I hate that job. And so I said, "I hate auto-scrubbing the gym and I'm going to run away because I hate it so much," and saw off my arms and cry. And she said, "LOL, that is the easiest job ever. Haha, I hope you never have to really work." Winky emoji like this. Ah. "If I had a choice between auto-scrubbing the gym and setting my hair on fire, I would be Joan of Arc. Also, I would volunteer as tribute instead of auto-scrubbing the gym." And she just said, "LOL, you go for it, son. Ha 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 ha. Ha." Those are the kind of things my mom has to put up with, but she is so great about it, and she always just laughs and goes along with the stupid things that I do and my siblings do. Once, we wanted her to do the nene, which is a dance like, oh boy. She did it, and it was quite funny, and we got it on video. But she's also very encouraging and helpful. I feel like I wouldn't even have a lot of the things that I have or be in the places I am or doing the things I'm doing without my mom. When I was running for student council, she helped do the posters, the slogans, the video, the handouts. She helped me do everything, and I probably would have given up if I didn't have her. And I would just be super homeless and very sad. Once, when I was in 8th grade, I was trying to do track, and I'm not athletic. That's... posh. Look at me. I can't do football. So I was trying to do track, and she encouraged me, even when all the other kids were like, you're slow, you're stupid, blah, 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 blah. And that wasn't necessarily true. I got fast and jumped further than I normally could. So she encouraged me, and she went and got me some shoes, and she just told me to keep going. That really helped. It was great, because that's what moms are supposed to do. When you look at famous moms throughout history, there's Mary, and the Brady Bunch mom, what's her name? Mother Teresa. I mean, she has the title Mother in her name. So that's, you know, her first name's Mother Teresa. Mother's Day probably was a big deal for her. She's dead now. Yeah, and then my mom, I mean, she definitely makes the top five mothers. But I also have a lot of women in my life who aren't necessarily my mothers, but are very influential, such as my aunts, who are not married, but are some of the most amazing people I know, Shannon and Tracy. I work with Tracy, and she's like my second mom, basically. And Shannon is so great. She taught me how to play poker and gives me candy. Also my grandma. I go to her house every A day for lunch, and she always has a nice meal prepared for me. And, you know, she always makes me eat my vegetables, which my mom kind of gave up on a long time ago. But she does it, so that's great. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I love you. To all the moms out there, thank you for what you do. Thank you for being moms. You are really appreciated. As they say in France. Oh, here. I got one. Mamma mia, we sure do love our moms. Mamma mia. Mamma mia. Mamma mia. Here we go again.